Whether you're a content creator or a social media marketer, you need a content calendar. Usually, we create it in Excel or using some other apps, but this video, I will show you how to create a flexible, smart, and very efficient content calendar using Microsoft Lists. Earlier, Microsoft Lists was a part of Office 365. It still is, but the good news is now free Microsoft account users also have access to lists, which is great. What is lists? You go to office.com, all apps, you'll see lists. Go there, create a blank list, and let's start from there. Even though the list is blank, it's not completely blank. There is one column always there by default. That's called the title column. It's a text type of column and it's mandatory. So might as well reuse it. So just rename it as content title. That's it. But the other columns which are required, we will have to add one by one. So these are the columns we are going to add. Category and type. Category is for the content. Type is for the type of content, like short, long. And then we have a deadline, of course. Where do you want to put it? Who is responsible for it? So few standard columns, but that's just a demo. If you want, of course, you can add as many columns as you want. How do you add a column? Click on add column. Now I'm going to add a category. Now, I do work on Word, Excel, PowerPoint. So, those are the categories. You may be doing work on different topics. So, you create your list. When you create any column, you have to decide, is this column mandatory or not? If it is mandatory, enable this setting. Whenever you add choices, color coding is automatically done. If you want, you can customize that as well. The next column is, where do I intend to put or post this content? There can be so many platforms or social media places. So I don't want to have one column for LinkedIn, one for YouTube, one for Twitter. No, we want one column with a list of all the platforms and I should be able to multi-select. That makes it more efficient. So again, it's a choice type of column with multiple selections allowed. Okay, done. The next column is the deadline when you intend to do it. If you want, you can add one more column, say, actually, when was it posted? So you can see this minus that. Did we do it on time? But right now, let's keep it simple. The date of posting. And the last column I want to put is person responsible. Now, person's name you want to write. It could be just a simple text box. But if you are in an Office 365 environment and all other people are also a part of that group or that tenant, then we have a special type of column called person column, where you put at the rate, put the person's name, it will validate, and that can be used for further automation. So now our list is ready. How do you enter data in the list? Two ways. One item at a time. If you want, then click on the new item. It creates a simplistic form. Just put the data there, done. If you want to enter like a grid, like Excel, then say grid view. There you can type multiple rows, one below another. It will still take care of validation, but it's more familiar Excel-like entry. You can use whichever method works for you. Great. So now, how do I get other people to enter data into it? No problem. Share, put their email ID, give them edit items permission, done. Edit list permission is special. That means people who have edit list permission are like owners of the list. We don't want too many owners. We want many people to add and edit data. So give that permission. They will get a mail, they will get a link in the mail. When they click on the link, they will be able to do entry right there on any browser. In fact, there is a list app as well available on mobile. Now, I know what you're thinking. Oh, multiple people are going to edit. That means they can delete each other's data. Yes. So, if you don't want that, go to that wheel or sprocket, list settings, advanced settings, and these two simple buttons you enable and job is done. What are these saying? If this person added the three rows, that person can edit or delete those three rows. That's fair, but that person doesn't know how many other pieces of data are in the list. So based on who you are, you will see only your data. Really good security, just two buttons to click. So we got a list of content items which we want to publish. Great. But now, on demand, I want it to be seen like a calendar. Sure. So that's called a view. By default, you get a view called all items. You can see it on top. Next to that, there is a plus sign. Click on it, create a new view. basically view means how should that data look like. Currently it's looking like a list. Now we want it to look like a calendar. Fine. So choose calendar. Now the problem is calendar requires some column which has a date, because that is what it's going to show on the calendar. We have only one date column, the deadline. So choose that. And then another setting. By default, will it show weekly view or monthly view? Most people like monthly view, and click OK. That's it. The same list now is visible as a calendar. No extra effort, one click. So you can switch between list and calendar instantly. I'm sure you got the idea. Now let's fast forward a little and say, OK, this is all well established. People know how to use it. So let's see grouping first. This button allows you to group on any column. In fact, you can go to any column and say group by this one. Easy and effective. This is ad hoc grouping I'm talking about. Similarly, you can filter. There is a filter pane, and in the filter pane, you can add specific columns, and then it becomes sort of an interactive filter. But sometimes you want a predefined thing. So in one click, I want this grouping and this filtering and this sorting order. So I've created a view called active work. When I go there in one click, I only see items which are pending. Published items, cancelled items are removed automatically, and it is grouped on category of topic. So all this happened in one click. How? Create a new view, customize it based on filter, sort, group, and save it. Finally, you may want to do some kind of analysis on your own. No problem. You can export to Excel. It'll give you raw data or directly create a pivot table. You choose. And then you can analyze the data further. If you want to, it integrates with Power BI as well. If you want to refine it further, this itself can become a mobile app where one at a time people can enter the data using Power Apps. And if you want to automate stuff saying, okay, once this is marked as published, inform someone, all that, yes, this integrates with Power Automate as well. So in Power Automate, you can say whenever a new row is added here or when an existing row changes, then do XYZ actions. The other problem is because we have more than one platform in one column, I may publish today on LinkedIn and day after tomorrow on YouTube. That's how I have planned. The related column is we have multiple destinations in one cell and we have only one deadline. So what if for each social media platform we have a separate deadline? That's not going to be supported in our current list. If you want that flexibility, then you will need two lists. One list gives you only the base content, and the second list is the actual content list. How to do that is a topic for a separate video. I'm sure you found this useful. So you know what to do. Like, share, subscribe, click on the bell icon. But most importantly, try it out and let me know if you find it useful. This is a new kind of content we are creating where it is specific to a role or a job. If you have any ideas in this regard, do post it in comments.